Starting to the top of the map, the only Terran player for Team FX Open. It is
FXO Kumiho.
Got that towel in there, a third and new towel. I've been keeping track of his towels.
A new towel. And at the bottom of the map, we have a new opponent for him. It is
Axiom Alicia.
ID comes from a Korean game, Dungeon Fighter. Actually, I think it might be a Chinese game, but it's quite popular in Korea, regardless.
Alicia has a 61% win ratio in the matchup, with 36 maps played. Kumiho has 62% with 35 maps played. So overall, both of them really good in this matchup on eye level here. But if you look at the recent games that they played, Alicia is definitely the one who was able to edge out more wins, and also against more renowned players. Kumiho has a bit of a loss streak here. He lost to Panic, Aria, Dia, Hero, and Sora. Those were just the last five best of threes or best of ones that he played against Protoss. So let's see what he can do in this game. It's quite important for him that he takes it.
Yep.
And then, of course, if they want to win today, Lucky has to defeat Innovation to bring it to an ace match.
Maybe that team contribution there at the bottom, you see Kumiho is actually the highest ranked contributor. And that actually includes Wings of Liberty stats, which is part of the reason why I think he is so highly ranked in the contributions. He just has, such a great consistency in Team League, as coming out and doing what he needs to do and showing good games. We did have a quick core here with only the 1-1 double gas. Now we got triple, and I think he's going to hide a dark... No, he just checks for proxies. No, I think he's going to hide a dark shrine down there, because that's a very unlikely place for a Reaper to scout on this map. And the reason why I think Dark Shrine and not Stargate is because if you want to hide a Stargate, you usually want to put it closer to your opponent, because that's the idea there. But it could be a Void Ray all-in with a slow Void Ray timing. You never know.
Yeah, that's going to happen.
It could surprise Kumiho. And there's the Twilight Castle.
You know what that is? That is exactly the build that Hurricane used in his Challenger League matches, with exact the same positioning.
Yep.
Against Bunny.
Yes.
That's like
same map, too, I think.
Yep. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, it's exactly the same map. It's exactly the same positioning for the proxy that that Hurricane.
Except in that game,
Bunny.
He put his Twilight Council on the main and fake Cronid.
Yeah,
it. That was the only difference.
He faked it, but not, yeah, the Dark Shrine was located over there.
Yeah, exactly. So it's not quite as sneaky, but
he doesn't fake him out, but that position becomes more and more popular.
By the way, we have double Reapers here. And you know what? With actually the double Reaper, this is going to become a problem. And he's going for a Blink all-in, so...
Yeah, and with the Blink, I don't see the double Reaper become that much
okay, yeah, so it
anymore.
Doesn't become a problem anymore, no. He immediately starts an Engineering Bay, and that's not going to be all too useful against this.
It's going to be great against DTs, though, which are probably not going to appear anytime soon.
Not anytime soon. If a Reaper goes down right now... then Kumiho might actually be out of luck for the whole game. Now the multiple Reapers shown, and he
four
saves
of them.
It.
He's
doing the
Reaper
build from All-Stars.
Exactly.
From All-Stars, yes, the All-Stars build.
He played the Reaper build back then and was like, yeah, I wanted to try it, and it actually worked. Was that on Fruitland? I don't even remember.
No, it was on, Tristram, actually.
Tristram?
If I'm not mistaken, I think it was on Tristram.
Yeah. He went for that build, and it was actually successful. So right now he's trying it again, this time against Alicia, and here they come, and there are not a lot of Stalkers.
Yeah, he needs to use his probes here, and actually the Mothership Core is so delayed. He something he knew when he did scout that there was no Mothership Core in production. One Reaper does go down, several probes kill, putting him down 20, but he still doesn't know about the follow-up here, and there's not going to be a lot of use. Another Reaper falls,
and this time we do not have the full commitment to the Reapers. This is something that he did in the All-Star game. This time he only has four of them. And here comes the Scout,
uh-oh.
And that Scout is going to find out what's happening here.
Yeah, and actually he's making Marauders at home, and he doesn't have a CC. So basically, the thing is, Alicia doesn't know. If he knew there was no CC, I think he might just start a Nexus and try to soft contain his opponent. But as it is, like, this is looking okay for Kumiho, because
Stalker has to turn around and kill shot that Reaper.
Yeah, I don't know what was going on there.
I think he did. Here we go.
I hope so.
One base versus one base.
One base versus one base. Bunker not complete yet. One Marauder, eight Marines, and a Reaper. Stim very exposed here, actually, as it is. And the Mothership Core is coming up to join. If the Bunker does not finish, Kumiho is in trouble. SCV is coming down to help out.
Yeah, he's trying to do what he can.
Here come the Blinks.
Takes down as many units as he can. The Bunker
finishes the Marauders.
One Marauder is in. The second Marauder is in as well. He tries to target the Mothership Core.
Yep. One Marauder, two Marauder, too many Marauder. Two more already coming up. This is kind of over. We have Reapers at the bottom left trying to do damage, but a warped in Stalker already chasing them away. I feel the best thing for Alicia would actually be to just expand now.
Yeah, I think so. Attacking against this, he doesn't know there's no CC. There could be one in the main further. He's going to start to wonder suddenly, why do you have Stim so fast? Once Stim is shown, okay, there's the Nexus.
He goes for the Nexus here. He starts his own base, and that is going to put him ahead.
Yeah, and he can start picking off Harvesters here, too. One goes down already, and they can get the depot as well.
And supply blocks going to be all there for. This, I mean, at the beginning, this looked like the beta of Wings of Liberty. One base versus one base. This is something that we haven't seen too much.
Yeah. He's got two force fields here, and that will grow to more.
And think about how long it's going to take Kumiho to actually get a star upgrade into a starport into the match and the Medivac so that he can break through here without a problem.
It's going to take a really long time, so the factory's not even done. Charge is the follow-up, which is a great choice. He already has that Twilight Council tech. He's basically costing Gumiho money in repair constantly, costing him money in lost mine time at the natural. And he doesn't have even a second command center still. Don't forget, so only one mule.
Yep. Four SCVs now needed. There's a lot of lost mining time that he has there. And this is looking pretty good for Alicia. His own expansion is nearly completed. Gumiho doesn't even have a CC started.
He's got to be so careful about trying to attack that Mothership Core, because if he gets time warped and loses five of his Marines, that even hurts him further. He's just going to let the depot go, and I actually like that choice because it was costing him more than it was doing him good. Now we can try to control any medevacs by blinking, but probably he's just going to walk away here, and he's got the charge almost done. Temple Archives, he can actually use double chrono since he has that second base, something that Gumi doesn't have. He also doesn't have that Marine that just died. And he's just going to keep using Hallucinated Phoenixes to see when is your CC, how many medevacs do you have, and where are they? Are they coming for me?
Yeah, and the only thing that Templar has is a bigger army. If that Storm finishes, what exactly is he going to do? A force field at the ramp, just in case. Scouting here with a Phoenix, and he's like, where is that CC? There's still no command center. He sees the army, and he's like, all right, so that's what's going on.
He's like, where are the medevacs? You know, you don't have medevacs coming out here either. And now, finally, he's just going to walk down the ramp. A bit of an oversight there by Alicia.
But the problem is, can he get the Storm out in time? The Temple Archive is done, but I don't think so.
I think he's just going to go Archon, Charge Zealot. And Mothership Core is way, way already going back. This is a smart choice. Where's the Mothership Core? Did it already get back? Because he's going to need it. He's going to need it hardcore here.
He needs that Photon Overcharge. He's trying to delay for as long as possible, but he knows exactly what's coming. He has the first Archon that he warps in. Mothership Core needs
full
to go
energy.
Over to that expansion. So.
Yeah, he's expecting a drop play. He's not expecting an SCV pull all in here. Although, to be honest, I feel he should be. He needs more Archons. He needs more Zealots.
That army supply for Gumiho is at 56 against 40. And here comes the Mothership Core. He goes for it. Here comes another Archon. Where's the Photon Overcharge?
There it is. Time warp 2.
Get those probes into the battle.
Yeah, the probes need to get in here. The Archon takes out all the SCVs, but he's going to need a lot more than that. He needs to let the Nexus go. He needs to walk up the ramp and let the Nexus go or use the probes, which he is doing now. Needs more Zealots. Where are the Warpets? Here they are. The probes actually pushing it back. Will Gumiho fall? He's starting to drop in army supply.
I think he's actually going to fall. He doesn't have it, but now he has the reinforcements streaming in. We have a cooldown for Alicia. The Harvester count is 15 to 31.
The medevacs are out of energy. He dances them back and forth. And he takes on the last of the Stalkers. But that Mothership is still going strong. He needs to go into the main base. Pick up and go into the main base. Gumiho. Trying to take out the Nexus, another Marauder joins the fray, the last Stalkers is
gone! He gets the Nexus,
and the probes are going to go down as well here. 33 army supply to 10, no energy on the medevacs. Those units so low on hit points.
Gumiho is actually
going to
take it!
He's making the winner by the main, by the way!
He comes up the ramp. I can't believe this is happening.
The second Archon is warping. It's not over yet, but a really good position for Gumiho.
Alicia realizes too late that there's no CC. He gets those gateways, but he doesn't get the round of warpings that he wanted. He overcommitted two harvesters, didn't get enough army supply, and Gumiho with the SCP pull, he just goes for it, YOLOs it in, and is going to take the game most likely. It's going to produce Widowmine's opponent's base.
You know, actually, it's not over yet, because
with the Archons, he can still push it back.
And not attacking like
points.
This, though. Well, he pushes it through. And
we need that micro now.
Oh, my God. Gumiho showing some great micro here. The Widowmine will not finish. Not finish the burrow there.
That is so dangerous. He needs to get those Widow Mines into the picture there.
Yeah, they're doing so much damage to Archons when they do connect. Look at the low hit points here, but now the medivacs join up. Yeah. And Alicia's overextended a little bit here.
Alicia is down to 18 army supply. Force gets field. 43. Here we go.
He's trying to snipe that Archon again. They're getting those shots off. The Sandu with the potential force field on the ramp could help him out as well.
Gateway goes down. Archon takes too many hits. He's going for the pylon. Chases the Archon. A few more shots will do it. Solo on shields. But good Zealot Warp in here. He's surrounded by both sides. But the medivacs healing
medivacs,
too much.
Medivacs could also lift and just evacuate if need be and fight another day.
The rest of the Marines coming in. And that is going to be it.
This is it. GG.
Kumio takes the second win for FX Open.
Wow.
Wow, indeed. What a crazy game. Starts things off with Reapers. Holds the pressure. And, you know, just does what nobody expects, pulls the SCBs. Woo! That was a crazy game.
Alicia probably can't believe what just happened. He expected a CC on that high ground.
Yeah.
And when he saw there was no CC, he immediately dropped so many gateways. He was like, oh my god, I have to get army supply, and I have to get it fast.
Yeah, he also expected more so just drops to try to pick him away instead of the SCB pull and attack by ground. He had Phoenixes flying all over the map trying to find the medivacs. He had the Mothership Core on the right side waiting to overcharge medivacs coming into the main. But the attack was at the natural. The Mothership Core a bit too slow.
Yeah, but even if he was there like a second faster, that would have wanted him to get the battle. It was just so much. The probe pull could have been a little bit faster.
Yeah, that's true.
Maybe
too.
That would have helped him there. If the probes take a few of the... Because at the beginning, he didn't really commit with the probes. He pulled them later. But if he does it right at the beginning, then I feel he's going to tank enough shots so that the rest of the army can do more damage. I think, actually, if he would have pulled the probes, he would have had a really good chance of holding them.
So Hurricane and Gumiho taking the 2 points here, but now Lucky has to go against Innovation. And if Lucky wins against Innovation, that we go into the ace match, that would be crazy. And I don't even know. The thing is, I know that Innovation will probably come out for the ace, but who will FX Open send for the ace if that happens? I hope not Taskstar.
I want to see Tassa, so you have to perform your handstand. But that's actually going to be really interesting since I don't really expect Leenok. You don't want to send in a TVZ. Well, let's maybe Lucky again. I mean, they put if Lucky actually wins against Innovation once, then Joe Eskert's going to be like, you know what? You're going to play the ace match now as well. You already defeated him once, and probably he's going to be the last player. But before we have an ace match coming up, we have to go into the last game of the regular lineup of the regular team match. So it's going to be Lucky versus Innovation, and I think we're going to have a 5-minute break before we are jumping into the next match, but probably they're going to...
We'll intro the players first, so we can talk a little bit more about how Innovation is extremely favored in this situation with his incredible win ratios against Zerg, and also the fact that Lucky just... He comes out sometimes as a sniper or sometimes as a closer, but it's very rare.
Yeah. I mean, the last time he really surprised us, he performed so well in the last time that we saw him in the GSTL, but this is now a little bit of a different scenario.
Yeah, I mean, I think right now, Choi is saying, you did it once, Lucky, please do it again, because it was the same situation where Lucky was the last man standing.
I mean, they already kind of fought their way back. They have won two of the matches right now, so they're only one map down in the team match against their opponent, and that might give them exactly what they need here to clinch it out. It is the best of one. Innovation can lose a best of one.
Yeah. And also Innovation doesn't want to show one of his normal strategies here because he wants to save that for BlizzCon. So keep that in mind as well. He may have to play serious now, though, because it all comes down to him. Ranked first in WCS points, 5-1 in GSTL, all killed FX Open last time. And he's sitting there going, well, I all killed you last time. All I have to do is beat one player.
Innovation has a 77% win ratio in this matchup.
Against the best Zergs in the world.
With 72 maps played. That's like not a lot.